فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
ما صليت صلاة, I never prayed a salah, منذ 40 سنة, 40 years, إلا وأنا أدعو فيها للشافعي, except I make dua for who? I make dua for Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah. And we are in excessive need of the what? لأخلاق العلماء, in the etiquettes and the manners of the ulama. Wallahi, we need it. Wallahi, these people are ulama rabbaniyun. They are ulama rabbaniyun, ahli sunnah, dhawil akhlaq al-azima, whose manners and etiquette was very high. We as students of knowledge, inshallah, even if we are, this is the kind of thing that we need to know. We have to recognize those who are before us in virtue, greater than us in nobility, more understanding of the religion of us, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honors them and He bestows His never-ending mercy onto them. That we love for our brothers what we love for ourselves. Our brothers who are out there, who are calling to the sunnah, who are spreading the tawheed, wherever they are. Some we have met, some we haven't met. Some of them we've met them, we've seen them, we've sat with them, we loved them when we met them. We saw nothing except the sunnah from them. And some of them we've never met them, but we've heard their ashrita and their tapes and their recordings. And what has that built in our hearts? By listening to them and hearing what they're calling to, it placed love in our heart towards them, and it made us love for them, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates them statuses, ranks, positions, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings the truth about. The truth of the matter is, sahibu sunnah, the person who's upon the sunnah, knows that he can't spread the sunnah by himself. He can't. He needs a'wan, he needs people to support him. He needs aid. From who? Other brothers and other individuals and sisters to come out and to spread the sunnah and the tawheed. The calling to the deen of Allah is not a business where if somebody comes, your business goes down. No, it's not. We're all trying to make the tawheed spread, especially at this time when the enemies of Islam are spreading their falsehood and their misguidance. The people of the sunnah need to be more and more hardworking and more on the front line than anything else. Now we're going to be speaking about Talamidh al-Imam al-Shafi'i, the students of al-Imam al-Shafi'i. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, he has Talamidh al-Kuthur. He has many students. One of the most famous students that he had in Baghdad is Al-Hasan ibn Muhammad al-Za'farani. He died in the year 260 Hijriyah. Muhammad Al-Hasan ibn Muhammad al-Za'farani. And Al-Husayn ibn Ali al-Karabisi. Al-Husayn ibn Ali al-Karabisi, who died in 248. And the most famous students that he had in Egypt are Abu Ya'qub, Yusuf ibn Muhammad al-Buwayti, Ismail ibn Yahya al-Muzani, Abu Muhammad. So Abu Ya'qub, Yusuf ibn Muhammad al-Buwayti, he died in 231 Hijriyah. Ismail ibn Yahya al-Muzani, he died in 264 Hijriyah. Ahmed, Abu Muhammad, he is al-Rabi' ibn Sulaiman al-Muradi. He died in 270 Hijriyah. And he's the narrator of the books of Imam al-Shafi'i, like Kitab al-Umm and Kitab al-Risala and others. He's the narrator. ولذلك, he's referred to as Rawiyyatul al-Madhab. He's called Rawiyyatul al-Madhab, the narrator of the Madhab. As Imam al-Dhahabi mentions that and uses that term for him in the Kitab As-Siyar al-A'lam al-Nubala, the 12th volume, page 579. Inshallah ta'ala, we will speak about the بعض الملامح في الفقه الشافعي, the stages and the marahil and the levels and etc. that Madhab al-Shafi'i consists of. Ama, the things that the Madhab al-Shafi'i stand on. Matters which the Madhab al-Shafi'i consists of, or is a component of. The first one is ما كتبه الإمام الشافعي بنفسه. The things that Shafi'i, he himself has written. And Imam al-Shafi'i is the only Imam الذي عرف بتدوين الفقه والاهتمام به. He's the only Imam who is known to have written, to have documented fiqh and given it importance from the four Imams. And he had written Al-Umm. Kitab Al-Umm. And the name shows what this book is. It's a mother. And it's a book that consists of what? Fiqh. That's the first thing that the Madhab al-Shafi'i consists of. The books written by Shafi'i himself. The second is ما رواه تلاميذ عنه. The things that his students have narrated from him. The students, what they narrated from him. ومن أهم رواة مذهب الشافعي للقديم. Now Imam al-Shafi'i, the narrators are of two types. Those who've narrated from him at his early stages, which is referred to as his old views. And these are the students of Baghdad when they narrate from him, like Al-Hassan ibn Muhammad al-Za'farani and Al-Hassan ibn Ali al-Karabisi. Al-Hussein ibn Ali al-Karabisi. If they narrate from Shafi'i, this is the qawluhu al-qadim. This is his old views that he held. And the narrators who narrated from him in his new views, which is referred to as al-qawlu al-jadid, his new views and his new opinions, are those who narrated from him in Egypt. And that is al-Rabi' ibn Sulaiman al-Muradi, who died in 270 Hijriya. And also Ismail ibn Yahya al-Muzani, who died in 264. And also Yaqub ibn Yusuf ibn Yahya al-Buwayti, who died in 231 Hijriya. If Muradi, Rabi' ibn Sulaiman al-Muradi, and Buwayti and al-Muzani, Ismail ibn Yahya al-Muzani, if any of them narrate from Shafi'i, this is the qawluhu al-jadid. These are his old, his new opinions. This is his new madhab. The third thing that the madhab consists of is التخريج على أقوال الإمام الشافعي. تخريج. Extraction on the statements of الإمام الشافعي. We'll come to what that means inshallah ta'ala. We'll speak about that inshallah in details. The fourth one is اجتهاد. Independent reasoning of أئمة الشافعية, of the madhab of the Imam of the Imam madhab Shafi'i, of Imam the Imam of the Shafi'i madhab. Their independent reasoning, the independent reasoning of the Imams of the Shafi'i madhab. If you now look at the structure of the madhab Shafi'i and what it consists of, it's really is similar to what? The Malikiyya that we just took. And the first one was what? مَا دَوَّنَهُ الْإِمَامُ الشَّافِعِيُّ بِنَفْسِهِ. That which Imam Shafi'i, he himself documented and what he wrote. The second one is مَا رَوَاهُ عَنْهُ تَلَامِيدُهُ. That which his students wrote, narrated from him. That which his students narrated from him. The second one is مَا خَرَجَهُ أَئِمَّةُ الْمَذْهَبِ عَلَى فَتْوَى الشَّافِعِيِّ. That which the A'imma have extracted from the verdicts and the fatwas of Imam Shafi'i. And the last is what? مَجْتَهَدَ فِيهِ أَئِمَّةُ madhab. The personal independent of the Imams of the madhab. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i's madhab, the documenting of it, or the writing of it, was done in two famous manners, two famous ways. The first one is tariqatul iraqiyin aw al-baghdadiyin. It's known as what? The way that madhab Imam al-Shafi'i was documented and it was written. It became famous through two ways. The first one is tariqatul iraqiyin, the tariqa of the a'immatul iraq. Tariqatul iraqiyin, put that. Or it's also known as al-baghdadiyin. And the second one is tariqatul khurasaniyin. This you will find very common in when Al-Imam Al-Nawawi does the sharah of the Kitab Al-Muhadhab li Abi Ishaq Al-Shirazi, Kitab Al-Majmu'. Nawawi uses those terms a lot. He will say, this is the madhab of the Iraqiyun. And this is the madhab of the Khurasaniyun. He uses that terms a lot. So what is the tariqatul Baghdadiyun? I'm a Baghdadiyin. Tariqatul Baghdadiyin or Iraqiyin is فَقَدْ أُخِذَ الْفِقْهُ فِيهَا عَنِ الرَّبِيعُ وَالْمُزَنِي. They took from only Al-Rabi' ibn Sulaiman al-Muradi, and they took only from Ismail ibn Yahya al-Muzani, only. The scholars of Baghdad, and the Baghdadiyin, the Tariqatul Baghdadiyin, or Tariqatul Iraqiyin, they only relied on Ismail ibn Yahya al-Muzani and Al-Rabi' ibn Sulaiman al-Muradi, only. And the most prominent scholars that took that tariqatul Iraqiyin Abu Baghdadiyin, who only relied on Ismail ibn Yahya al-Muzani, and they only relied on who? Al-Rabi' ibn Sulaiman al-Muradi, is Abu al-Qasim al-Anmati, who died here 288. And then after him, Al-Qadi Abu al-Abbas al-Surayj. Also, after him, Muhammad ibn Ali al-Qaffal al-Shashi. And the person who became very well known in documenting this and writing it as a proper, well-written way is Abu Hamid al-Isfrayini, who died here 460 Hijriya. And then after him followed in that way al-Mawardiyu and Abu Tib al-Tabari. Al-Mawardi died here 450 Hijriya. Abu Tib al-Tabari, he died in 450 Hijri as well. And Adam ulama al-A'lam. That's well known. Very good. Now we are left with the second tariqah, tariqatul Khurasaniyin fi al-Tadwin, which is also known as the al-Mirawiza. Al-Mirawiza, na'am. Al-Mariwaza. Na'am. Al-Marawiz is correct, na'am. Al-Khurasaniyin. So Tariqatul Khurasaniyin, which is fi tadwin, or it's also known as the Al-Marawizah. It's also known as Al-Mirawizah. This one became very common and well known on the yed of Al-Qaffal al-Saghir. The one that I mentioned before, the first one that I mentioned, Muhammad ibn Ali al-Qaffal al-Shashi, this is known as Al-Qaffal al-Kabir. This one, on the other hand, he's the Saghir one, who died in 417 Hijriya. And many followed him on this path, like Abu Muhammad al-Juwayni. Al-Muhammad al-Juwayni, who is who? Who is Al-Muhammad al-Juwayni? Huh? No, it's the father of Abu Ma'ali al-Juwayni. And Al-Mas'udi, they took this path. And then after that, many scholars came after them. And what they did was, they combined between Tariqatul Iraqiyin or Al-Baghdadiyin and the Tariqatul Khurasaniyin or Al-Marawizah. They combined between the two tariqah, the two paths, and they made it into one. It was the first to do that was Imam Al-Haramain, Abi Ma'ali Al-Juwayni, rahimahullah, in his illustrious and noble great book, نهاية المطلب في دراية المذهب. And then Imam Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni, when did he die? He died here 467. And Abu Hamid al-Ghazali, he died here 505 Hijriya. What he did was جمع بين الطريقتين Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni. Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni, he gathered between the two madhabs. And the two ways and the two paths, he made it to one. Sah? He made it into one. And then after that, of course, Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni, when he finished, his student took over. Who's the student of Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni? Abi Hamid al-Ghazali. Ghazali took from his teacher and he carried on. And here they gathered between Tariqatul Iraqiyin and the Tariqatul Khurasaniyin. Who are the most prominent a'imah of the Madhab al-Shafi'iyah? They are known as the A'lam al-Madhhab al-Shafi'i. They are the heads and the figures of the Madhhab al-Shafi'i. Who the Madhhab al-Shafi'i stands on, they're the backbone. And truly, to be said, it's two individuals. Two individuals are the backbone of Madhhab al-Shafi'iyyah. The first one is Al-Imam al-Rafi'i, who died in the year 623 Hijriah. He died in the year 623 Hijriah. He is the author of the Kitab Ash-Sharh al-Kabir. And the second one is Al-Imam al-Nawawi, who died in the year 676. 676. He wrote, Al-Imam al-Nawawi wrote three books. The first one is Minhaj al-Talibin. The second one is Rawdat al-Talibin. And the third one is Al-Majmu', which is a sharh of Muhaddab li Abi Ishaq al-Shirazi. Madhhab al-Shafi'i. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Madhhab al-Shafi'i. The tahqiq al-Madhhab. If you want to strengthen Madhhab al-Shafi'i, and you want to do, because the muhaqqiqin of the madhab are who did I say that the madhab stands on? Al-Rafi'i and Nawawi. Al-Rafi'i and Al-Nawawi. Rafi'i, he died in the year 623, and who's the explainer of the Kitab al-Sharh al-Kabir. And Nawawi, who died in the year 676, who authored the three great books, Minhaj al-Talibin, Rawdat al-Talibin, and Al-Majmu', which is a sharh of Muhaddab ibn Ishaq al-Shirazi. Here now I have to mention and I have to bring to your attention something very important, which is that the madhab al-Imam al-Shafi'i, the madhab of al-Imam al-Shafi'i, قد استقر على رأي الرافعي والنووي. Madhab al-Shafi'i's, it solidified itself based on the opinions held by Nawawi and Rafi'i. If you look at it and you follow it up, the istiqrar and what it goes back to and what it results to is the opinions held by al-Rafi'i and Nawawi. فَمَا اتَّفَقَ عَلَيْهِ النَّوَوِيُّ وَالرَّافِعِي. Anything Nawawi and Rafi'i agree upon. أَنَّهُ هُوَ الْمَذْهَبُ فَهُوَ الْمَذْهَبُ. If Rafi'i and Nawawi agree, both of them, that this is what the madhab says, this is what Shafi'iyya madhab is, then no one argues it, everybody takes it. وَمَا اخْتَلَفَ فِيهِ. Anything they both differ on. فَمَا جَزِمَ بِهِ النَّوَوِيُّ جَزْمًا فَهُوَ الْمَذْهَبُ. If both of them differ, but Nawawi comes and he gives a unwavering conviction and he says it is the madhab and he pushes it, then they say it is the madhab. They give Nawawi a bit of superiority and a bit of station over Rafi'i. وَإِلَّا فَمَا جَزَمَ بِهِ الرَّافِعِيُّ. They don't give it as much as they give what Nawawi does. As for if Nawawi is unsure of a matter, he says, he states it, but he's unsure of it, and he doesn't do jazm. He doesn't mention with unwavering conviction, then Rafi'i does unwavering conviction, they give it to Rafi'i. They say Rafi'i's view, he's the one who mentioned jazm, he takes priority. Very good. After that, so we have Nawawi and we have who? Al-Rafi'i. We're now going to go a tabaqa lower than them, a station, a level lower than the two of them. ثُمَّ مَا قَرَّرَهُ فِي الشُّرُوحِ. Then the Shafi'iyya give importance to what are mentioned in the explanations of the works of Nawawi, like Kitab Minhaj al-Talibin. Because remember, who do we say that the Madhab al-Shafi'iyya stands on? Rafi'i and who? From within them two, who's the higher one? Nawawi. So Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala, and Imam al-Nawawi, his Kitab al-Minhaj, this book, any shuruh and explanation and commentary that are put on it, especially the Kitab Tuhfatul Muhtaj by Ibn Hajar al-Haythami with a ta, and the Kitab Nihayat al-Muhtaj by al-Ramli, some of the Shafi'iyya, they see that the madhab is ma rajaha Ibn Hajar al-Haytamiyyu. Some of the scholars, they see whatever Ibn Hajar al-Haytami strengthen is the madhab. And some of the Shafi'iyya, they see whatever al-Ramli strengthens is the madhab. Why? Because both of them are what? لِأَنَّهُمَا Because both of them are شَرَحَا مِنْهَجُ الطَّالِبِينَ Because both of them, they explained which book? مِنْهَجُ الطَّالِبِينَ Which was written by Imam Abu Zakar al-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala. وَلِذَلِكَ كِتَاب مِنْهَجُ الطَّالِبِينَ أَصْبَحَ الْعُمْدَةِ It became the backbone of the madhab. And through the shuruh, they give tarjihat. They strengthen it based on the shuruh and the explanation that are put in it. So some places in the world, if you go today, which they follow the madhab al-Shafi'iyya, they strengthen what? They strengthen Ibn Hajar al-Haytami. And some places in the world, if you go, you see that they strengthen al-Ramliyu in the madhab. And that is important when you're speaking about هذا أمر مهم في ضبطي حكاية المذهب عند الشافعي. This is an important point that a person needs to give importance to when he's speaking about the madhab al-Shafi'i. Now we're going to, inshallah ta'ala, so before we move on, we have to understand this one. What did we say? We just said that the Shafi'i madhab, the people in which they became truly affected by, or they inclined to their views, is who? Al-Nawawi and Al-Rafi'i. I said Al-Rafi'i has a kitab called Al-Sharhu Al-Kabir. And I said Nawawi has three books. He has Minhaj al-Talibin, Rawdat al-Talibin, and he has the Majmu', which is a sharah of what? Al-Muhadhab li Abi Ishaq al-Shirazi. Then I said to you, if Nawawi and Rafi'i agree, this is the madhab. If they differ, they look at if Nawawi mentions an unwavering conviction, and Rafi'i mentions unwavering conviction, who's given superiority? Nawawi. They go towards Imam Nawawi. If Imam Rafi'i rahimahullah mentions a view, and he mentions unwavering conviction, but Nawawi doesn't, they give it to who? Imam Rafi'i rahimahullah. Then we said, since Nawawi has now become more superior than Rafi'i, are you with me? The kitab which the Shafi'iyya made their umda, their book they rely on, is the kitab which is Minhaj. Minhaj al-Talibin, written by Nawawi. Minhaj has two prominent shuruh on it, two prominent explanations on it. The first one is the what? Tuhfatul Muhtaj, written by Ibn Hajar al-Haytami. Ibn Hajar al-Haytami, who died in the year 974 Hijriah. And the second one is Nihayatul Muhtaj, written by Al-Ramli, who died in the year 1004 Hijriah. These two Imams, Ibn Hajar al-Haytami and Al-Ramli, are both what the Shafi'iyya do tarjih on in the madhab, because they have the sharah on a kitab which is mu'tamad, a kitab which is truly relied on, which is Minhaj al-Talibin by Nawawi. So some places in the world who follow the madhab al-Shafi'iyya, they will strengthen based on what they read on the Tuhfatul Muhtaj by Ibn Hajar al-Haytami, and they will say this is what's muqarrar inda al-madhab. And some places of the world when you go to, you'll find that they strengthen the Nihayat al-Muhtaj by al-Ramli. So there's that distinguished factor between the two, which you will find. Now we're going to move on to speaking about بعض المؤلفات في المذهب الشافعي. Some of the books that are written in the madhab al-Shafi'i. طبعاً, of course, we're going to start with which book? By Imam al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah. This is the most famous book. And then comes after that, the Mukhtasar al-Muzani. Imam al-Muzani is Mukhtasar. Ismail ibn Yahya al-Muzani, rahimahullah. Ismail ibn Yahya al-Muzani. Who died in year? What year did Imam al-Muzani die? I mentioned it. Hey, Sa'ad, when did he die? Al-Imam Muzani, rahimahullah, he has a Mukhtasar al-Muzani. And then they give import, and then comes after that, Nihayatul Matlab fi Dirayatil Madhab, written by Al-Imam Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni, rahimahullah. That kitab, Nihayatul Matlab, has been summarized. Nihayatul Matlab has been summarized. By who? It's been summarized by Al-Imam Abi Hamid al-Ghazali, with his kitab Al-Basid. And then Abi Hamid al-Ghazali, rahimahullah, he summarized his Basit into Al-Wasit. Al-Imam Abi Hamid al-Ghazali, he summarized his kitab Al-Basit into what? Al-wasit. And the ulama, they gave a lot of importance to these mukhtasarat and these shuruhat. So they explained it and they went over it. Some of the books that have been placed explanation on is the what that are one of the shuruh that Shafi'iyya give a lot of importance to is Al-Bayan, written by Yahya Al-Umrani, who died in 550 Hijriya. Rawdatu Al-Talibin, written by Nawawi. Al-Hawi Al-Kabir by Al-Imam Al-Mawardi. And the Ta'liq of Abi Tib Al-Tabari on it. And the Ta'liq of Qadi Hussein on it. And the Bahrul Madhab by Al-Ruyani, who died in 502 Hijriya. And the Muharrar by Rafi'i. And the Minhaj Al-Talibin by Imam Al-Nawawi, rahimahullah. What I'm, inshallah ta'ala, going to place on the bottom of the video, inshallah ta'ala, is a diagram for these books and how they come out from each other. There's a diagram, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to put how the books have come out from each other and the explanation on each book. Inshallah, when you watch this video, bi'idhnillah, at the bottom, you're going to find the diagram on it, inshallah ta'ala. Now I'm going to mention some of the mutun al-mashura inda al-shafi'iyya. Some of the most famous, well-known mutun written in the madhab al-shafi'iyya. One of the most famous one is the kitab Matna Abi Shuja'. And that inshallah ta'ala, which is very well known as Matna Abi Shuja', but the real name of the kitab is what? Al-Ghayatu wa-Taqrib. Okay? This kitab, we're going to speak more about it inshallah ta'ala when we finish this madkhal inshallah. This kitab, Matna Abi Shuja', has many shuruh and explanation on it. One of the other books, the mutun, that the ulama give importance to in Madhab al-Shafi'iyya is the kitab At-Tanbih, written by Abi Ishaq al-Shirazi, who died in 476 Hijriya. Also, there's another kitab, which is good, mashallah, is called the Muqaddimah, the Introduction al-Hadramiyya, written by Abdullah ibn Fashil al-Hadrami, who died in 918, sorry. Before Nawawi al-Rafi'i came, there were five books which Madarul Fiqh al-Shafi'i, Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, five books that Al-Imam al-Shafi'i's fiqh revolved around, five books. And then after that, it all came back to Rafi'i and Nawawi. The five books are Mukhtasar al-Muzani, Al-Muhadhab, written by Abi Ishaq al-Shirazi, Al-Tanbih, written by Abi Ishaq al-Shirazi, Al-Wasit, written by Abi Hamid al-Ghazali, and last but not least, Al-Wajiz, written by who? Al-Imam al-Ghazali. These five books were Madarul Fiqh al-Shafi'i. Shafi'i's fiqh revolved around these five books. And then after that, these five books, they all came down to Al-Rafi'i and Nawawi. Are you with me? They came down to what? Al-Rafi'i. Rafi'i, he wrote his kitab Al-Sharhu al-Kabir. In Sharhu al-Kabir, he put all of those five books in there. Nawawi, on the other hand, he wrote the kitab, as I mentioned before. He wrote Minhaj al-Talibin, Rawdatu al-Talibin, and the Sharh of Al-Muhadhab by Ishaq al-Shirazi. In these three books, he put all of those five books in there. Very good. And we mentioned, of course, Al-Imam al-Nawawi's kitab Al-Minhaj. What did we say about it? Specifically, Shafi'iyya, they took that book on more. Okay, they took the kitab Minhaj and they sat with that book. And as I said to you, there's two prominent sharuh, two prominent explanations that they took. One, of course, is the sharah written by Ibn Hajar al-Haytami. And the second one is the sharah written by Al-Ramli. Those two is what they sat over. And a person who studies Madhab al-Shafi'i, if he studies Matna Abi Shuja', and he finishes Matna Abi Shuja', and he makes his way up after studying, of course, the kitab Zubad by Ibn Raslan, and he does Yaqut al-Nafis, and then he does what you call Umdat al-Salik or Umdat al-Nasik by Ibn al-Naqib al-Masri, and then after he goes to kitab Minhaj by Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah, and then when he does Imam al-Nawawi's Minhaj, and he does it with the two shuruh sharah I mentioned, the first sharah being Ibn Hajar al-Haytami, and another sharah is, he does the sharah of al-Ramli. This person is strong in Madhab al-Shafi'i, very strong. Knows the madhab very well. He knows the madhab very well. Now, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to go into ba'd al-mustalahat, some of the mustalahat, some of the terms that are used in الشافعية في كتبهم, that the Shafi'iyya use in their books. Okay? The first type of terminology that I'm going to start with, that I'm going to choose, is when the Shafi'iyya use the word al-imam. Shafi'i, when they say قال الإمام, the imam said, who are they referring to? They mean Imam al-Haramain, Imam al-Haramain, Imam al-Juwayni rahimahullah, Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni. If the Shafi'iyya say al-Qadi only, they say al-Qadi, the Qadi said, who do they mean? They mean al-Qadi Hussein. If they say عند القاضيين, with the two qadis, who do they mean? They mean الرويani and الماوردي. They mean الرويani and الماوردي. If they say قال الشارح, the explainer said. If they say the شارح said, the explainer, and they leave it unrestricted like that, they mean by this جلال الدين المحلي, who died in year 864. Because he's one of the explainers on what? Al-Minhaj by Imam al-Nawawi. Okay? That's when they say, لكن قال الشارح. Of course, they make it مُعَرَّف. Alif al-Lam, then it doesn't refer to anybody other than جلال الدين المحلي. But if they say, of course, قال الشارح, شارح, شارح. شارح without Alif al-Lam, then of course they mean whatever book they are explaining, the one who, the book that they talk, they're going over, the person who explained that book. If they say عند الشيخين, with the two sheikhs are, عند الشيخين, with the two sheikhs. Or if they say قال الشيخان, the two sheikhs said, who are they referring to? They mean الرافعي and النووي. If they say الشيوخ, if they say the shuyukhs, they make it plural. Who are they referring to? They are referring to الرافعي and النووي and Subki. Subki died what year? 657 Hijriah. When the Shafi'iyya say al-aqwal, al-aqwal, when they say al-aqwal, what do they mean by that? It means the speeches that are attributed to Imam Shafi'i. When the Shafi'iyya say al-awjuh, when the Shafi'iyya say al-awjuh, mean forms, phases, what do they mean? It means al-ara, the opinions, التي يستنبطها فقهاء الشافعية. It is the views and the opinions that the Shafi'iyya extract bida'an ala qawa'idihi wa usuli, based on the principles and the foundations of the madhab. When the word at-turuq is used, turuq, paths, it means that ikhtilaf al-ruwat fi hikayat al-madhab, that the narrators have differed regarding the transmission of the madhab. Good. If they say al-adhar min qawlayhi, al-adhar min qawlayhi kada, what do they mean here? Al-adhar means there's a zahir. Yuqabiluhu al-zahir. It's the opposite to zahir. Meaning there's other opinions which are right, but this is the most apparent one. When they say wal-mashhur min aqwali imami kada, when they say the word al-mashhur, what do they mean? This is the famous. And the opposite to it is what? Yuqabiluhu al-ghareeb. Any view other than this is strange. It has been transmitted, but it's strange. Very good. This is some of the mustalahat التي ترد في كتب الشافعية. These are some of the terms that come in the books of the شافعية. Inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to conclude there بإذن الله الكريم. Anything which I have said wrong, incorrect, is from me, الشيطان. أن الله and his messenger are free from it. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.